Oh my god, it's been so long. Let me order a drink with it. Let me order a Coke. Okay, let me order a Coke and come back. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to today's video. Yet another video. Oh my god, it's been so long that I have actually sit down and shot a video. I mean, shot a YouTube video. But I thought of doing this kind of chit-chat session which kind of reveals the life update of mine, and I also thought of just letting you know what was going on in my life and give you an explanation why I was not posting any videos on any of the platforms. And yeah, it was a rough time and I thought of just sharing everything with you. With that, I'm actually spilling some other things which might be a little controversy, but I thought of just talking to you guys and letting you know what I'm actually thinking about these things. There were a couple of things which were going on in my life due to which I was like kind of invisible on YouTube, and I really owe you all an explanation. So here I am doing that, and with that, let me make this video a little interesting. So yeah, I have a mukbang kind of setup. It's not lot of food, but yeah, I do have my fried rice, and I do have my soya manchurian, and I really love this. With this too, I do have Coke. I thought of just letting it in the same bottle and just throw it away after drinking it, not shifting it into another bartan, which kind of I should clean after this video. Okay, yeah, that's it for the food related. Yeah, I do have water also for obvious reasons. If you like watching it, please do give it a like and do subscribe to my channel. I'm back on YouTube. I have actually shot more videos in this type which I was invisible on YouTube. I have shot couple of more videos also. I just need to edit it up and put it on the channel. So there are so many videos which are coming up. I'm really excited for the September month and obviously October month, which is my birthday month. Okay, you're not going that far, but yeah, so September month is a kick-ass month. I'm very much motivated to work this September, and yeah, please do subscribe guys. It really means a lot to me. Please do subscribe and give it a like also, and do let me know what you were going through in this quarantine period. So yeah, without any further ado, let's get started. Let me just take a bite and then start letting you people know about the first thing which I really wanted to talk about, because it's there in my head for a couple of days and it's bothering guys. It's really bothering me. So what happened is, it might be eating ASMR also. I don't know. I really don't know why I am doing this, but yeah, I enjoy watching this kind of video, so yeah, I'm doing it. The first thing which I really wanted to tell is about a particular YouTuber. There was something going on her YouTube channel. I don't want to mention her name or anything like that. Before me being a YouTuber, I'm actually a viewer and a serious viewer, because yes guys, I really enjoy watching YouTube videos and I do follow a lot of YouTubers. A lot of YouTubers in general, and I really like those people. And this YouTuber whom I am actually addressing in this video, she's a well-known YouTuber with lots of followers. There is something which happened recently. She have posted one random video of something, and it is the same video. She have done the same thing repeatedly. She is definitely good at heart and she is a very good talented YouTuber, but after reaching certain point, if you just check her videos out, most of her videos are very similar, just one or two difference, but very very similar. So people were, I mean the viewers who are actually subscribed to her channel, they were actually disappointed, yes, to watch same content again and again. We are not actually subscribed to any of the YouTubers if there is no use in, no matter in that video to watch. But there were a couple of people, I mean there were more people who were kind of still supporting her. I agree, whatever it might be, but many people were disappointed by watching those videos repeatedly on the channel, because it was the same, guys. I cannot reveal what is the content and all, but it's the same, literally the same. If you have actually watched her content and have seen whatever related to her Instagram or YouTube, you'll definitely know whom I'm actually addressing in this video. I was a viewer of her YouTube channel from almost a year now, and I really love the content which she creates. I really love her differentiation also with the content and all. Recently she have started a different angle of different genre, I can say, but her normal, heart of the YouTube channel is similar, guys, like literally similar. So the viewers, they were actually disappointed because of the same reason. And she recently posted a video which was a similar content, and people were disappointed, and they have actually left comments on her video stating that so and so, we are not actually looking forward for these kind of videos. And there were a ton of comments, guys. It's not like I'm not joking. So even I felt the same. I actually commented first time on her channel stating that no, this is not what we are actually looking for. This has been repeatedly done and we are not actually looking for these kind of stuff. And it was not a hate comment or something. I was disappointed. I just said that I am disappointed to watch similar content again and again, and this take it as a feedback or something. I just left the comment, and then I have checked the comment section. There were lot of the similar comments, guys. Everyone were disappointed. There were a couple of comments here and there stating that yeah, we do like the video, but most were disappointed. I came out of that video and I was doing my regular chores and all. Then when I checked my phone, I got a notification from YouTube that somebody have replied to my comment and liked my comment or something like that. So I checked that, and they were also expressing the same thing. They agreed for what I was saying, thinking that yeah, we are also disappointed. Yeah, I agree with your thing. She's not listening after we giving continuous feedback. She's just posting the same thing after reaching so and so subscribers or anything. How can she behave like this? This is not the way she should respond or something like that. She didn't even like what, and blah blah blah, or so on and so forth. Just like those comments and just came out of it. And after some time, I got some other notification from YouTube regarding the same thing. Somebody commented on my comment. So then I checked it, and then I saw that my comment is not there, and the comments which were there, which I've liked before, were also not there. I couldn't see those comments. Then what I did, and I went to that video and I checked, the comments were turned off. It's her choice, whatever it might be, but as a content creator, I know whatever the hard work which goes into a particular video when you are actually shooting that video. I really know how it all works, what is behind the camera and all. But when I felt disappointed, it's from the YouTuber perspective. I hope you understand what I'm talking about. So I really felt bad, guys. She didn't give an explanation. She just threw some random thing that so-and-so, which was not a clear explanation why she was doing it again and again after knowing that her viewers are not liking that. There are so many top YouTubers who are doing very well after reaching so-and-so point also. They really, really think about every single video and put out very genuine content, and they really work hard on each and every video, even though they are like, they have millions of subscribers. I felt that if I'm not liking some if the content of that particular channel or whatever it might be, it doesn't matter to me, then I should just leave that YouTube channel. And I unsubscribed. So I unsubscribed, I unfollowed her, and I'm peace with it. But I really felt bad that she have done that. She have taken her viewers for granted or something. Because yeah, we should, in this particular industry where everybody grows on viewership because of the viewers, because of the subscribers, yes, you should not do it to the viewers. If they are actually sharing some feedback, definitely you have to take it and work towards it. I completely agree that I was kind of MIA on YouTube for many times. I have genuine reasons for that. Apart from that, regarding video things, whatever the request and all, whatever the feedback which you have given, I have definitely taken it and worked towards it. This is what I'm talking about. Every single small YouTuber also, they do work hard and put out content which are kind of liked by viewers, but not like, they don't take people for granted. And one more thing I don't like about this particular person is she says that she doesn't resonate with drugstore brands, whatever the affordable brands and all. And she says that I only use so-and-so brands, so-and-so luxury brands and all. And she takes up the normal drugstore promotions and promoted for the sake of money. See, I have a problem with it, just because, well, if you're promoting any brand, you have to use that to be genuine on YouTube. YouTubers in this community who don't actually think about that and promote random stuff, that is up to them. This is also up to her, but whatever I felt, I'm actually sharing it with you guys. So I felt that kind of manipulating, because if she doesn't resonate with drugstore products, she shouldn't promote those. Just because of the money and all, she can promote those, and for her usage sake and whatever it might be, she used luxury products because she don't resonate with drugstore. Yeah, so this is what I felt very bad about that YouTuber. I don't want to name her. I'm talking a lot and eating very less. Yeah, so the next thing is, and one more thing, guys. As a YouTuber, I really wanted to tell you people, tell my viewers, that there are so many other YouTube channels which kind of promote skin lightening using some baking soda and something bleach and some random things which you can't even imagine, and they kind of Photoshop the thumbnail and they manipulate you people. And many people have actually addressed, for example, Shweta Vijay, Shreya Jain, those people, they have actually addressed this kind of YouTubers, but they're still on the platform, guys. And you people are believing those kind of videos and giving those a view, and those people are having millions and millions of views and subscribers, and yeah, they are earning a lot also. Please don't believe those kind of videos. Please remember that it is the science thing. You cannot lighten the skin tone what you already have. You can just remove the tan and dead skin, and that's it. Please do not believe all these videos and do not use them on your skin. It might give you a very bad reaction, and please don't put yourself in that kind of situation. I really, really urge you, do not try it on yourself, and don't even watch these kind of videos. They try to manipulate girls, and especially in India, they try to manipulate you people, and especially in India, people are behind this lightening thing and whitening thing. They are like manipulating and making you all fools. Apart from that, those videos, they don't work even though you use it. Please don't believe those kind of videos and don't fall into the trap and just giving them more importance in your life. That doesn't matter, really doesn't matter. You end up in a very difficult situation which you don't want to be in. So please don't believe and don't get fooled by those kind of videos. Now coming back to my stuff, I don't know, I really wanted to tell you people about what was going on in my head from a couple of days. So I just told you, but okay, now let me start giving you my update. You people know that my mom and dad were here, and finally, after a long struggle of the flights and Vande Bharat mission, they have gone back to India, and that is a different story altogether. If you want a story time on that, just let me know. I'll just do a separate video for that, because it was a roller coaster. So yeah, they have gone back to India now, and they were there in quarantine, and yeah, they're very safe and sound in our house right now. So if you want me to just put up a story time telling you people what happened and how it all happened, just let me know. I'll definitely do story time for you guys. What is happening with you all, guys? What are you all doing these days? Is your area safe and sound, or do you have any cases in your area? In India, man, the cases are growing like anything. Here it is kind of normal. We do have like 200 to 300 cases per day in whole UAE, which is very okayish. So everything is open here, and people are roaming like they have never seen corona time. And yeah, people are roaming in malls. Everything is open for even people are actually coming from other countries also for visiting Dubai. There are a lot of summer festivals going on, so we are actually expecting a lot of tourists. I don't know. But the preparations are going on, so yeah, everything is kind of back to normal, and the cases are also kind of okayish. When my mom and dad were here, nothing was open, everything was closed. When they were going back to India, then everything started, like malls got opened, and we have visited to Dubai Mall also, and we have visited to a couple of other tourist places so that they can at least have fun. But apart from that, most of the places were not opened. So yeah, it was kind of disappointing, because they came here for to see all these places. But I know this was not a good time, but yeah, it was kind of disappointing. But you know, me and Rakshit, we had a very good time with mom and dad, because this time we don't get it in any near future or even in future. I don't think so. We get almost like 3 to 4 months, almost 4 months, 10 days they were here in our at our place, and we don't get this kind of time in future. We can't stay for 4 months or so many days together. I don't know, it might not be the same, but this was really, really memorable, and we enjoyed each and every part of it. So yeah, it was definitely worth so that we can have good time, good quality time as a family, because before marriage I actually didn't have any good communication with my parents, because just because of he was here and he just came for the engagement, and after then he came back, and then he came for the wedding, and then we came back. So we didn't find that free time to just sit and talk with our parents, both of us. So yeah, it was kind of good spending time with mom and dad. But at the same time, we felt a little bad because we weren't able to show them different places. After everything was opened, we actually been to a couple of places, and we just went out with our friends for outing, and I have vlogged it, guys. Even though I was kind of MIA on YouTube, I vlogged it. It was almost 2-3 weeks before, but I vlogged it, and very soon it will be up on the channel. So please don't miss it. Please subscribe, and okay, let's come to the main point why I was not posting videos on YouTube. When mom and dad were here, I couldn't find a specific time to shoot and post, because our timings were different. Our sleep schedule was completely changed, and the mental space was not very clear to be creative enough to post videos. I really don't want to post shitty videos without any good content or entertaining, at least to just for the sake of it. So I didn't post any video, and after they have gone, I kind of miss being with them, and to come out of that particular lonely space, I took some time. And still, when I was going through all these things, I used to sit and write ideas about YouTube and script and all different plans which I have, and I used to journal a lot. And even though when I'm cooking or when I'm doing something, I suddenly get an idea, and I just leave that and go sit and write and just plan everything up. I do have notes about everything, so there are so many videos which are creatively coming up on the channel. So yeah, I have done that, but I don't know, I was procrastinating a lot and thinking a lot about shooting a video and putting up on the channel. And you know what, I have actually shot 2-3 videos also when I am kind of in the same phase, and I don't know for what reason I wasn't able to put it up on the channel. In between, what happened, you know, there was some issue with the laptop, and it couldn't read a card, so I couldn't even copy those things to the laptop and then to the hard disk, because yeah, for the obvious reasons. So I couldn't do that, and I don't know, I was just procrastinating things and thinking overthinking about the things, and I was feeling very, very lazy, and I don't even know how to actually put it up for you guys, but I was like really, really overthinking about whatever it was going on in my life, and I kind of became little emotional also in this particular time period. I don't know why, but yes, I have actually changed a little bit. And yeah, we used to sit and talk about so many different things, and I really, really have to thank Rakshit, because he have motivated me a lot in the sense, lot, because almost every other day he used to ask me, what are you doing, are you working on something, please work on something, then you can come out of it. So he used to sit and just talk to me about everything, and I don't know, might be because of all the things which were going on around me, and everything kind of overwhelmed me, due to which I kind of like came into this particular space. But apart from that, I'm kind of good, I'm happy, I'm going good. Okay, we are actually back after changing the card, and the card which I was using was full, so I kind of like transferred the data, and I'm actually starting again. So I hope I was talking about my situation. So I kind of ended in that particular place, which I don't want to be. And I wanted some motivation to kind of get started and put that first step to restart everything again. And yes, as I said, Rakshit was helping me a lot with everything, and yeah, that kind of motivated me to start new and shoot this particular video. I have shot couple of videos in this time period, but this video I was really, really excited about, and I planned, I cooked everything, and it was really good to see myself in this particular happy space, and I really want to be in the same space. I cannot even imagine of doing some other thing like a normal 9-to-5 job right now, because all I want to do is YouTube, and I want to grow my career in this platform and do work on whatever it might be. I have actually started this channel on a particular motivation, on a particular agenda. I have seen many plus size YouTubers in different countries, but there are not many plus size YouTubers and who talk about like their body and all in India. I really wanted to change that particular So I have actually started this channel to kind of change that, and people are normal, they cannot be modelistic all the times, they cannot be perfect all the times. So yeah, I just wanted to share to my fellow friends who actually think just like me and who are very much normal and not looking for those models and Instagramming kind of figures. They don't have those kind of body for whatever reason it might be, and still we should be confident. This is what the motivation to actually start this particular channel when I started. So I really wanted to take it forward and work on this particular thing and grow my career in YouTube platform. So please do support me in doing that, and I really want all your support. Please let us just spread how much ever love we can, and please ask your friends to subscribe to my channel. It's a friendly thing. Please, please, please do share this word. Yeah, that is it for today's video. I couldn't finish up the complete fried rice and Manchurian, but I'll eat after this video. But I really had fun doing this particular video, and I kind of like let everything out, and I shared everything with you guys. So I really hope I made sense in this particular video, and do let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, and do subscribe to my channel, and please do follow me on my Instagram. The handle is right on the screen in front of you, and it will be linked in the description box below. Go check it out. I'm kind of active there also. I am kind of like very active replying to DMs when you kind of message me. So please do follow me there also, and I'll see you very very soon with another fun video, fun challenge video I can say. But yeah, very soon I'll be meeting you guys with another fun and very glam new video. So yeah, see you very very soon. Until then, take good care of yourself and keep loving yourself, and damn it, you're gonna do this. And I love you guys so much. Mwah. Bye.